Hello, welcome to 9design 3D. Today we will make basic type revolver gun in this tutorial. First, we will add our reference image. You can search on Google and find something about the different type of images because I will use more than one references and I will mix up. First, we will add a mesh circle to our scene and scale because we will make barrel part. In tap to edit mode, E to extrude for the back. And after that, Z to wireframe, or from the top you can go there. Choose bottom part of the edge line and G to move in Z axis. As you see, it will look like that. You can delete half of it, X and delete vertices. After that, we will add a mirror modifier and check axis Y. Don't forget to check clipping. And now we can continue to this. Add two loop cut with Ctrl R and S in Z axis. You can move it because we will make a slot part in this gun. For E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. Right click, shake smooth, and from the normals, check your auto smooth. And now we will add a bevel modifier and increase your segments. And you can S in Z axis for make thin slot in here. Add a loop cut again with Ctrl R. And after that, you can E to extrude in this front side. G to move your vertices. Especially, we are moving with our vertices and adding extra loop cuts with Ctrl R and G to move or giving a shape. If you want, you can give some roundy and shape or matching or reference image. Choose these two faces and G to move to the down. As you see, I'm making same thing. Adding another loop cut from the vertically and moving my vertices for giving a shape for matching with my reference image. And E to extrude for back part of it. For the triggers card, you can add again extra loop cut with Ctrl R. For this loop cut, you can scale in Z axis as a zero. E to extrude again for the down part. Add extra loop cut for the triggers card, round the shape. If you want, you can find some another images from the internet and mix up your gun. Because if you want, you can use it with the game asset. How you want, this is your model. E to extrude this down and round the parts of the trigger guard. And G to move. I deleted these two faces from here with the Alt selection. Choose them. As you see, we have to open our loop cut, edit preferences, add-ons, type loop tools, and loop tool bridge. As you see, it will be bridged and our vertexes will work clearly. Choose your top faces of your barrel and you can set your front and back sides. From here, you can move in y-axis because we have mirror modifier still. Add two loop cuts in here to make these face areas. You can set your loop cuts between these faces. And after that, E to extrude in y-axis and move in y-axis. They will stick together because we checked our mirror modifiers clipping. For the front side, you can E to extrude top parts and give a shape how you want. Now, we will make our cylinder. First, we will add a cylinder and after that, don't forget to cap fill type triangle fan and vertices 32. You can scale and place it. For not important to match all of it with your reference image. Put it and choose some faces with the checker type. Now You can E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. We will make outside slot part and right click shape smooth and auto smooth. Now you can delete these faces with X. And now we will add a subdivision surface modifier in here, increase your level viewport. After that you can add extra loop cuts for your subdivides making clearly and Ctrl A to apply it. As you see some extra edge lines in here, we can delete them. Actually don't delete them, press X and dissolve edges. If you delete them, your shape will be broken. Now choose your back faces and delete these faces now. Now press F to fill back and front parts because we will use our boolean modifier. Add a cylinder again, shade smooth and auto smooth, and scale them in x-axis and shift it to duplicate around it. I duplicated it 6 times and after that Ctrl J to join them. Ctrl A, all transform and set origin to geometry. Make same thing for the cylinder. And now we will add a boolean modifier. Choose as an object your cylinders. Ctrl A to apply it. And as you see, our revolver gun cylinder is ready. You can scale and type it. For the top barrel part, you can choose these faces and E to extrude in x-axis. For make longer for the back part. If it's some glitch or bad look in here, you can add extra loop cuts because we have bevel and subdivision surface modifier. They can be cause a bit of glitchy look in your model. As in here, you can use with Alt and E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. You can make your rear side shape. And now you can add some extra loop cuts for the hammers part. Choose the faces in here. Choose your vertices in here. As you see, it looks roundy because of the subdivision surface modifier. I to inset for the top rear side. E to extrude and add a loop cut. Give your shape. If you want, you can add different type of the sides in here. G to move which edge you want because we have mirror modifier. Don't forget to use the species. Ctrl B to bevel for this and scaling y-axis for your rear sides. And that's it. Now you can choose your back side for your gun and E to extrude and G to move in y-axis. You can merge at center these vertices. Now we will make backside of our cylinder. We will add a circle and in tap to edit mode, E to extrude. For this backside, E to extrude, right click and S to scale. And E to extrude again, S to scale. And E to extrude, this look like the ball type other part. You can Alt S to scale. This cylinder will look like that. You can scale it and F to fill. After that, you can Ctrl B to bevel for giving round the type. In Z to wireframe, you can choose half of it. Press P and separate them. After that, delete one of it, give a shape, and we will give a mirror modifier for make things easy. Don't forget to check your y-axis. And back part is ready too. Let's make our barrel and muzzle parts of it. You can G to move your vertices and give fully round the shape for this. But we have to get a topology in here for ourselves. For this, E to extrude and G to move your front part. Move these edge lines and vertices. Give circular shape. This is your gun. How you want, you can make it. As you see, I downloaded a different front view reference from the internet. I will use it. Choose front faces from here for the muzzle and X to delete your faces. And after that, right-click loop tool circle. You can give a circular shape for your muzzle and scale and give a round shape. After that, choose the circular round faces and E to extrude in Y axis. Move your vertices and edge lines. Give a circular shape to this. For the back part, you can choose these faces, scale, after that, E to extrude in Z axis. And you can move them and give a round shape for this too. You can add extra loop cut in vertically and scale, move in Y axis. E to extrude to these top faces and scale them. For the front side, which type you want, you can use it. You can mix up some different gun models. I will make it. I'm making this front side from the other reference image. And for the back side, I'm making from the other reference image. How you want, this is your model. If you want, you can use this as a game asset, or you can add extra parts and give some animation if you want for your animations. I'm showing only basically how to model this with a good topology. I'm trying to make it good topology. Maybe it's not work. I don't know. How you want, you can set it and search for some textures. It will make it tidy up. For the trigger, I am adding a cube, and again in the wireframe, I am E to move my vertices and giving a trigger shape with the round. That is the trick about it. We are trying to match it with our reference image and using good topological shapes. As you see in the solid view, it can cause a problem because it not looks very good. And especially it's easy in tap to edit mode, move your vertices and edges. You can give a shape. We will add a subdivision surface modifier. And we adding extra loop cuts in here. We will give a roundy and lovely shape to our trigger. I will apply all my modifiers. And for the hammer, we will E to extrude these parts for the inner slots. Don't forget to check your auto smooth. We will make hammer with the same method. I am adding a cube and scale it. Every time in Z to wireframe, I am moving my vertices and edges and adding extra loop cuts in here. For making a smooth something, I am adding extra loop cuts for my shape. Horizontally and vertically, I am adding extra loop cuts with Ctrl R. And my hammer shape is look like that. You can scale it and adding subdivision surface modifier and scale again. If you want to give an animation, you can model it with the detail. Now it's time to make our grip parts. You can add again a cube and Z to wireframe. You can add extra loop cuts for giving this shape. G to move your vertices how you want. There is too much different grip for the revolver guns. Maybe you can make it wood or leather how you want. I am making leather type. I will delete half of it. And again, with the same method, I am adding mirror modifier. Don't forget to check your clipping. For the space areas, you can choose them. And E to extrude in Y axis. And again, E to extrude and move your mouse in the Y axis. Now I will add a subdivision surface modifier again, and I'm increasing my level viewport. You can add extra loop cuts for the shape. From the mblcg.com, I downloaded this metal material as a 2K, and for the leather, I'm downloaded this for the grip part. Let's add our material. For the shading, before this, go to Edit, Preferences, in Add-ons, and type Node Wrangler. Don't forget to check it, because we will add our textures map with Ctrl Shift T. When you press Ctrl Shift T, you can choose all your maps and they will come in here. In Tap to Edit mode, you and Smart UV project, as you see, our textures are really look nice. For the others, you can set your same material. And for the grip, I will add my leather, Ctrl Shift T and choose your leather maps. And don't forget to check you and Smart UV project. Our gun is ready. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.